everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a video all about my morning self-care routine. So I do like doing a bit of self-care in the mornings. It doesn't always have to be in the evening, you know. And this is what I do kind of on the weekend on a Saturday. So I always start with a hair mask. I tend to do this actually before I wash my hair every time. So I wash my hair about twice a week. I'll put a hair mask in beforehand and then leave it for about 20 to 30 minutes. I just pop it through the ends. I did already have a little bit in before I started filming the video, which is why it looked so greasy. It wasn't, it was just the hair mask. But I'm just showing you how I'm putting a little bit in the end, you know, just to show you what I do. Focus it especially on the end, you know, because that can wear it be all dry. But then I will tie it up with a scrunchie. This one is a scrunchie by Scrunchies by Beth, which is a little small business on Instagram. And I just absolutely love her scrunchies, you know, supporting a little small business. And the hair mask I actually used was by Garnier. It was in the coconut scent, which is so nice. This just makes me feel so pampered, and I love doing hair masks. And then I will go on to a face mask. So this is a L'Oreal clay mask. I have particularly bad skin on this day, as you can see just a little bit on my forehead there. I think that was because I'd worn makeup a few days before and forgot to take it off when I fell asleep. You know, you shouldn't do that, but I just focus it all on my T-zone, which you can see popping it over my nose especially. There we go. You will see me pull a lot of funny faces in this video. I had a lot of fun editing it actually, because I didn't realise how expressive I can actually be. Thumbs up. And then it's Lauren in the bathroom. I am giving my teeth a brush, you know, it's boring, but it's part of my morning routine, so I added it in. And then back to Lauren in the studio, who has disgusting nails. I'd done these on my birthday a few weeks before, so I'm removing the nail polish. This is my favourite part of the video. Look at my face. Why do I look so angry and concerned? I laughed at this so hard when I edited the video. But I'm glad that's over. I take it all off. I do then do a base coat, and then I'm doing some Essie nail polish today. I actually got this from TK Maxx. If you're ever looking for Essie nail polish, have a look in there when it's open, because they're so nice and cheap. And then I read a little bit of my book whilst I'm letting my face mask, hair mask and nails dry. Who said that self-care and reading needed to be on the evening? It's my favourite time to do it. Then I wash it all off. Thumbs up, you'll see a lot of thumbs up in this. There it is again, nice and fresh. And here's me straight out of the shower. You can see me with my pink face, but then into my skincare routine. So start with the Pixi Glow Tonic, which is a chemical exfoliator. And I pop this all over after putting it on a cotton pad. It's really nice to soften my skin. I always see a massive difference in my skin after I've used this actually, and take it down my neck. You know, I'm trying to use every last scrap because it's not very cheap. Then my favourite moisturiser in the world is the Clinique Moisture Surge. My skin cleared up massively when I started to use this. I used to have awful acne, and by simplifying my skincare right down to just washing my face and using this and massaging it in, you can see I do it for quite a while. I cut loads of this out, but then I will do an eye cream. I haven't tried this out for long. I got sent this by Look Fantastic. It's a Revolution eye cream. It's pretty cool because it's purple. But I have a lot of problems with my eyes. It's kind of my problem area because I have eczema on my eyelids, and I'm trying out different eye creams. I think I prefer the one I used to use from the Superdrug, which is a vitamin E eye cream. But I'm giving this one a go, and then treating myself to rolling my face. I used to do this every day. I saw a massive difference in my skin when I use this, but I just don't find the time at the minute. So I do it definitely as part of my self-care skincare routine, pushing it all away. As you can see in a particular motion, it just feels so nice. And then onto a little bit of goodness in the ends of my hair. You know, I washed all the hair mask out, and then I'm adding, I think this has got coconut in as well. I love using coconut things in my hair. I am planning on cutting all of my, not all of my hair off, but going kind of shoulder length, maybe in 6 months to a year, and then donating a lot of my hair. So I'm keeping it very healthy and very long at the minute. And I just used a wet brush by Tangle Teaser as well, which you would have seen there. Now onto a little bit of lip balm. Burt's Bees is my favourite lip balm to use. I always react badly to lip balms. I always dry my lips out, but for some reason this one doesn't. So, and now onto the makeup. I start with a drugstore foundation, which is a L'Oreal Infallible Foundation, and blob it all around. This is just one pump, but I tend to use maybe 1.5. You'll see me do a little bit more in a while, because it doesn't tend to cover all of my pink cheeks after my skincare routine. There you can see I've just added a little bit more, and then I'm blending it all in. Me blocking my face from you. Next is my concealer, which is the Collection Lasting Perfection Concealer, and I just put that underneath my eyes and on down my nose, on the little spot on my forehead. I know you probably shouldn't put it straight on top of spots, but it's just a little lump that I had, you know, it's not an actual open spot or anything. Then I always massage it in with my fingers first. I just find this helps so much to blend it in because it warms it up, and then I use the brush afterwards. I just really, that's the way I do it. And you can see it's a little bit light for me, but I focus it down the center of my face, so it's not too bad. And it doesn't cover up everything that I want it to do, so I do tend to put another layer on, which you can see here. But I really don't put loads and loads of makeup on my face, so you will see, you can still see the little spot on my head, but you know, it really doesn't bother me. Everyone has blemishes and stuff like that. I was filming a video after this, so that's why I was putting my makeup on, but I was happy with that. And then I have the classic Stay Matte Powder by Rimmel. My mum got me this for Christmas. I hadn't used it in ages, since I was in like year 8 or 9 at school, but it is so good. I've had so many expensive powders and loose powders and things, but this one, you know, it's just one of the favourites, and it's like £3 or £4 or something like that. And then onto my kind of bronzer. This is by Too Faced. And it was in their Christmas collection a while ago, but they just have really, really nice makeup, Too Faced do. And I just use this to kind of bronze my face back up a little bit, because my makeup does tend to be a little bit light for me, and I just like to bring a little bit more colour around my cheeks. And I just enjoy doing makeup, like I really love doing the bronzer part of it. I just find it quite fun. But you can see all of my facial expressions. I was actually using the camera to do my makeup at this point rather than a mirror. And then a little bit of blush. I never used blush at all for years and years. This was the first blush I'd ever owned, because it came in this kind of Christmas set from Too Faced, and I actually really, really like how blush looks. You can't see it massively in this part of the video because of the lighting, but I do think it just adds this really nice flush to your cheeks, and it's just fun to do. And then highlighter on all of the high points of the face, as you would normally do with highlighter. I just love doing highlighter. These are all my favourite bits, I think. Blush, bronzer and highlighter. I don't tend to do contour or anything, just the basics. And then I will put a bit of highlighter in my inner corners as well, just to brighten up my eyes, make me look a little bit more awake. And then onto eyebrows, I use a little number 7 kit. I really, really recommend this. It's got some wax in it and then some powders. I use the wax first, which is what you will see me do now. It just helps me keep my eyebrows in place. I don't know if anybody else is like this, but my eyebrows move all day long. They will move up and down, and they're so messy, and this just stops them from moving and also helps the powder stick. You can see how, what difference it's made with the powder as well. Going through my eyebrows, that looks so much better than it would without the wax in there. And I do spend quite a while on my eyebrows, but I just really enjoy doing that as well. And I don't do makeup every day, so I kind of see it as a bit more of a treat than a chore when I do it. And I also love brushing my eyebrows through. I don't know why anybody else just love brushing their eyebrows through. Oh look, they're all done. I looked very excited about that. And then on to eyeshadow. This is the palette again by Too Faced as part of that little Christmas collection, but I literally just use like a white shade and skin colour shade. And then I tend to use like a little pinky champagne-y shade all over, and I just put that on with my finger. Nothing special, not very glamorous. And then I'll put a little bit through the crease of like a light brown, which you can see me doing now. It's really not too much or fancy. I'm very, very natural with my makeup, and then the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. It's just a little mini one, but I absolutely love this mascara. The only problem with it is it is quite difficult to get off at the end of the day. I will see that it's literally on my eyelashes for like 3 days afterwards. But it is a really, really good mascara. Oh, look at that mascara face. I remember I found this funny when I edited too. And then that's all done. And now on to drying my hair. I've got my Tangle Teaser brush again. This was also sent to me by Look Fantastic and I absolutely adore it. I mean, it's pastel pink, so why would I not? Pink is like my favorite color in the world. But it does take me quite a while to dry my hair. I mean, you can see it is really long. I kind of like plain expressions because I forget I'm on camera, and then I look like Hermione Granger when it's done. So I then have to kind of go through and straighten it. But this is my natural hair after I've dried it. It's quite fluffy, but you know, it's not too bad. But I was filming, so I wanted to get it all nice and straight. So another scrunchie. I mean, I have like a million scrunchies around the house, so I just tie up the top section of my hair, straighten the bottom first, and then I will let the top down and then straighten the top. So that is kind of the best way for me to do it. I've found that my hair is quite thick, so it is difficult to actually get it to stay straight. So separating it is good. And this is exactly how I would curl it as well. I'll separate it up. And there we go. Look, I look very excited about that. I'm nearly done, but this is kind of something basic. I don't do anything really fancy with my hair. I just keep it nice and straight and then natural makeup. And then we are all done. I hope you guys liked watching this video and give it a thumbs up. Bye.